8th December, the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Solemnity. A reading from the Discourses of Saint Anselm. O Virgin, by whose blessing all nature is blessed, sky, stars, earth, rivers, day, night, and all things that are meant to serve man and be for his good rejoice because of you, Our Lady. Through you, they have in a way come back to life, enriched with a new grace that words cannot describe. When they lost the noble purpose of their nature, for which they had been made, of serving and helping those who praise God, they were like dead things. They were crushed, disfigured, and abused by idol worshippers for whom they had not been made. They rejoice now as if they had come to life again. Now they are made beautiful because they serve and are used by those who believe in God. A new and priceless grace has made them almost leap for joy. They have not merely felt God Himself, their Creator, ruling them invisibly from above, but they have seen Him visibly within themselves, using them in His work of sanctification. These immense benefits have come through the blessed fruit of the blessed womb of the Blessed Mary. Through the fullness of your grace, the things in the lower world rejoice in the gift of freedom, and the things above the world are gladdened by being renewed. Through the one glorious Son of your glorious virginity, all the just who died before His life-giving death rejoice that their captivity has been ended, and the angels delight that their half-ruined city is restored. O woman, full and more than full of grace, all creation has received of the overflow of your fullness, and its youth has been renewed. O blessed and more than blessed Virgin, through your blessing all creation is blessed. Not only is creation blessed by the Creator, but creation blesses its Creator. God gave to Mary His Son, the only begotten of His heart, equal to Himself, whom He loved as Himself. From Mary He fashioned Himself a Son, not another one but the same, so that by nature there would be one and the same Son, both of God and of Mary. Every nature is created by God, and God is born of Mary. God created all things, and Mary gave birth to God. God Himself, who made all things, made Himself from Mary. In this way, He remade all that He had made. He who was able to make all things out of nothing, when they had been defaced, would not remake them without Mary's help. God is then Father of all created things, and Mary is Mother of all that has been recreated. God is Father of the institution of all things, and Mary is Mother of the restitution of all things. God begot Him through whom all things were made, and Mary gave birth to Him through whom all things are saved. God begot Him without whom nothing at all exists, and Mary gave birth to Him without whom nothing that exists is good. The Lord is indeed with you, for He granted to you that all nature should owe so great a debt to you jointly with Himself.